Don't forget to subscribe and turn the notifications. We upload daily, and check the source of this video to view all the images and videos if there was any. A couple were left devastated on the wedding day after being told just 4 hours before they took the vows that the hotel their guests were staying at had shut down. Adam Bral, 37, and his bride-to-be, Anna Lewandowska, 40, were excited when family arrived in Nottingham from Poland and London for the big occasion. Around 17 of the guests were expected to check into the stage hotel on Saturday, June 30, so they could drop off their bags before the ceremony. Adam Bral, 37, and Anna Lewandowska, 40, pictured on the wedding day, were excited when family arrived in Nottingham from Poland and London for the big occasion. But just as Mr. Bral was about to put on his suit and tie, he was hit with the news that the hotel he had booked for the guests had closed down, and they were left stranded with their suitcases outside. The hotel in Gregory Boulevard, Nottinghamshire, was closed after council chiefs labelled it a source of antisocial behaviour and crime. A judge ordered a 3-month shutdown on June 29. But this news had not reached the couple, and Mr. Bral said the hotel had not warned them of the closure or reimbursed the £355 the couple had paid in advance. Shop worker Mr. Bral had to come up with a backup plan 4 hours before he was about to marry the love of his life. The hotel in Gregory Boulevard, Nottinghamshire, was closed after council chiefs labelled it a source of antisocial behaviour and crime. The couple are pictured outside it. He rang around Nottingham hotels to find a suitable alternative, but to no avail. So when this failed, he raced down to Argos to buy airbeds and ended up putting the 17 guests up in his 3-bedroom Bestwood home. He told the Nottingham Post, "On our wedding night we had our friend's daughter who is 6 sleeping between us and the bridesmaid was on an airbed in the room with her husband. We had 9 people in the living room and also had someone in the bath. My best man had nowhere to stay but did not want to worry me and found a hotel but paid a lot more." The couple claim the hotel did not inform them of closure or reimburse the £355 they paid. He said the hotel informed him to pay by cash in advance as it would be cheaper than booking online, but despite many calls he cannot reach the owners and get his money back. "My wife was very unhappy," he added. "I was not happy. It was embarrassing. How can you celebrate if your guests are going to have to sleep outside?" His daughter Magdalena, 18, told the Post, "It was really embarrassing. I kept thinking, what are we going to do now? My mum was really worried. I just did not know where we were going to put these people so they could sleep because all the other hotels were full." Mail Online has tried to contact the Stage Hotel, but no one was available for comment.